Hi guys, welcome back to Amy's Kitchen. So I got a message from my good friend Sheila asking me to please, please, please do a video on how I make pozole. If you're not too sure what it is, it's basically just a pork soup and a chili broth with some hominy. And boy, is it delicious. Well, mine is anyways. So I'm gonna grab the pork, grab the rest of the ingredients, throw my hair up, and we're gonna start cooking.
Here's a list of ingredients that you'll need. 3 to 4 pounds of pork neck bone, 4 to 6 pounds of pork, either pork shoulder or pork butt with the fat trimmed, skin removed, chopped into large cubes, 25 to 30 dried red chili, either California or New Mexico, whichever you can find in your area, 1 to 2 large cans of Mexican style hominy, drained, 2 to 4 pig's feet, 1 bulb of garlic, and 1 onion. And you'll need salt. And to garnish or top your pozole, you'll need shredded lettuce or shredded green cabbage, lemon cut into wedges, finely diced onion, finely diced cilantro, crushed red chili, and oregano.
All right, so I have my water warming up and I'm just gonna add about 2 palmfuls of salt. I have my onion that I just cut into quarters, 1 whole onion, about medium size, 3 cloves of garlic. Just leave them whole, just make sure they're peeled. And use 2 to 4 pig's feet. And again, you can pull these out once the pozole is done. Or if you like them, then go right ahead like my grandparents and dig in. But it's just for the flavor. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a lid on it, leave it on high, and let this boil for 30 minutes, come back, and then we'll add the neck bones. So now for my neck bone, I'm just gonna go ahead and start placing them in. You can use tongs if you'd like. These are quite large. That's just what we had at the grocer. So I'm gonna let these boil for 30 minutes. Now it's time to add the meat. I got the meat all in my pan. And now I'm just gonna let it cook together, turning the flame down to medium high. I'm gonna cover again. I'm gonna check it in about 30 minutes for the water level and to start skimming any gristle or foam or anything that's at the top. And I'm gonna let this boil for 2 hours. So the pork has been boiling for about 1 hour and 45 minutes. And now I'm just gonna go ahead and get the chili prepared. So I'm just taking the dry chili, twisting the tops off, go ahead and just get some of the seeds out. I'm just dumping them into the trash. I'll do a few more so you guys can see. If all the seeds don't come out, don't worry about that. Just get as much out as you can. No need to do more work than necessary. Just twist the top off, dump the seeds. See? Super easy. All right, so I'm gonna get the chili prepared and I'll come back to show you the next step. All right, so I went ahead and took the skins off and seeded about 25 chilies. And I like to rinse mine. If you don't want to, you can skip this step. It's just something I like to do. So I just give them a good shake in there. Dump the water, let the water fill, and get it on the stove. Boil it on high, putting the lid slightly to the side, and let it boil for 30 to 45 minutes. Okay, so it's been about 40 minutes and my chilies are just the way I like them. You see, I'm not sure if you could really tell, but they're just really soft. That's what you're going for. You let them boil for 30 to 45 minutes and there's no way you can mess this up. make sure I got them all out. I got just a couple more. I'm gonna go ahead and place my 3 cloves of garlic, and I'm gonna go grab some broth from the pozole. All right, so I grabbed 4 ladles of the broth, and now I'm just gonna add 2 ladles of, let's do 3, of the water that the chili boiled in. We're gonna add 2 palmfuls of salt. Don't be shy. And now for the loud part. We're gonna go ahead and blend this on puree for about 4.5 minutes. So I'll see you guys back when it's done. Okay, so it's time. The chili's all ready. So now time to pour in. You wanna be careful pouring it in because it will splatter back at you. So just make sure you get it as close to the pan as possible. I'm gonna grab some water and rinse out the blender. Add that. And now for my hominy. And I just went ahead and opened both cans and I just drained the liquid. I do not rinse my hominy. If you would like to, please feel free to do so. Get both cans in. Be careful, it will splatter and burn you. That's why I like to use a spoon. Takes a little longer, but trust me, it's worth it. And I'm gonna let this boil for another 30 to 45 minutes. And then, baby, it's time to eat. So I'll see you guys back in about 45 minutes. All right, guys, and there we have it. Delicious homemade pozole. I have my pozole served, and I'm gonna go ahead and garnish it with some chopped onion. Grab a little bit of shredded lettuce. I put cilantro in mine. Squeeze a lemon. My daughter puts about 4 or 5. I just use 1. I'm gonna grab a little bit of crushed red chili. I like mine just a little spicier. And we just toast up some corn tortilla. I made some fresh avocado. If you would like to see how I make a simple and easy one, go ahead and, or guacamole, go ahead and comment down below and I'll share that with you guys. And now time to eat. So I'm gonna roll this. This is just how we like ours. This is optional. Everything is optional. Excuse me, go ahead and dip that in the broth. Oh my God. You guys have to make this at home. With fall coming up, it's the perfect comfort food. My house smells amazing. It tastes amazing. The family's over here staring at me as I'm tasting this, so I gotta get them fed. But I just wanna take a quick bite. They can wait just a second. Thumbs up, like Raleigh says. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, share, and follow me on Facebook. I'm now on YouTube as well. And I hope you guys make this one at home. I know your family will love it as much as mine. You guys have a good night.